Do you remember this case I posted on the social platforms? Let me explain what's behind this case. Hi, I'm Dr. Kai. I'm a radiologist specialized in arthritis imaging, and I'm going to tell you a little bit about our daily life when reporting hand and feet x-rays. So here we can see this case of a 70-year-old woman who has been complaining about pain in her finger and toe joints for about 9 years. She never had any real swollen joints, and blood sampling, it turned out that CRP was elevated with about 6 mg/L, and also there was positive evidence of rheumatoid factor and ECPA antibodies. So now what can we do with these x-rays? I already aligned both of these x-rays side by side here in the BerlinCaseViewer app. I think it's important for you that you always try to do a side-by-side comparison. And when we analyze these x-rays, of course, we approach this joint by joints group. That means we first look at the DIP joints. Later on, we look at the PIP joints. We look at the MCP joints. We look at the CMC joints, the intercarpal joints, the radiocarpal joint, and also the distal radioulnar joint. We take special care to analyze the stylite process of the ulna. We look especially at the MCP joints, as those are affected most frequently. And we do not forget about the sump. So when we compare these two x-rays, it's already evident that there is some cyst-like change here in the third MCP joint. So this is a difference between the sides. So it would be nice to have a second plane of this lesion. And we happen to have this oblique projection of the fingers. These oblique projections, they are not always done. Maybe even in the lowest percentage of cases they are done. So this is something that needs to be taken into account, that sometimes you only have the AP projection. And if you look at this lesion over here, you can see it's a cyst-like lesion within the bone, and also you see there's a small sclerotic rim surrounding it. So it can be many things. It can be a ganglion cyst, can be an erosion, can be a tophus in gout, maybe some strange stuff like enchondroma, but I think enchondroma would be larger and also maybe would not have this sclerotic rim. Okay, so it would be a good idea to also analyze the other joints, namely the joints of the feet. Because with this one lesion, you cannot establish a diagnosis, and it's not even clear that this is an erosion at all. So we are looking at the feet. So we are comparing the AP views of both feet. And here again, we go joint by joint. Sometimes it's difficult to analyze the DIP joints. And here we take special care to look at the MTP5 joints on both sides and also on the IP joint of the big toe. In a general overview, it looks quite unremarkable. However, when we compare the two images and the two x-rays, we can see, and especially if we enlarge about the same magnification level, we can see there is some irregular structure here in the spongious bone that is not here. And again, an oblique projection would be nice. And in fact, we have it here from the left side. And if we enlarge that one, we can clearly see that there is some defect here in the cortex. So we would call that an erosion, because we now see the clear disruption of the cortical layer. So this is a clear erosion in the typical location, MTP joint 5. And then again, we look at the right side, enlarge again, and there are some cystic lesions over here. And even if you enlarge it large enough, you can see, and if you compare it with the opposite side, we can see that usually the cortical layer should go up to the medial edge of the basal phalanx. And here we see there's a disruption of the cortex, and we see there's cystic changes over here. So this might in fact be an erosion as well. So the question was here, how many erosions are there? 0, 1, 2, or 3? So we saw this lesion at the hand. I think this was not compatible with an erosion, but we saw the lesion at the fifth toe. So that is an erosion. And also for those of you who are in favor of an erosion here at the MTP joint 1. So 2 and 1, these are the two correct answers. And also, if you don't care, that is also not a bad thing. As usually, you, in the, when you start the training, usually it's very difficult. So I gave you a green check mark here as well. So what can you see after you did answer the question? Of course, then you saw again all the images now with explanation. So you could see which lesions we thought were typical for erosions that are marked in yellow. And also we called this a cystoid lesion, not an erosion in a proven sense. So that is what you got. And also you got this learning text here to read about how we do the interpretation of these changes. In addition, also it happened that new x-rays appeared. These were not new x-rays, these were old x-rays, but suddenly the patient made them available. So we can now compare the old lesion that we find here in the MTP5, this one, switching these erosions this off, and we maybe take the oblique projection over here and enlarge it a bit. And 4 years earlier, the same foot had this appearance. So you see that this was all like it should 4 years ago, and now it is, and it is destroyed. So it's an erosion. And also, I want to take the time to discuss again these findings of cyst-like lesions in the MCPs. So this was a troublesome lesion for us when doing the interpretation, and therefore we studied it in depth, what we can see behind it. And we did a CT comparison, which we were able to publish in Arthritis and Rheumatism in 2012. So it's a rather early work. And what we had a new CT, and all of these patients with these cystic changes were included in this CT scanning experiment. And we had a couple of patients scanned, and some of them showed this cystic changes with the sclerotic rim, and it was in fact covered by bone. So we did call this like a ganglion cyst, maybe due to osteoarthritis. And then in the other half of the patients, we saw similar lesions, and they were open to the outside. So we called those erosions. And about 50% of our patients with the cystic lesions had in fact already erosion. So that is why I recommend you take special care of this pattern when doing reports of the x-rays of the hand, because some of these patients may have already an erosion. So you should do an either ultrasound or an MRI in order to check for the cortical break, because if an erosion is evident, usually that is a warning sign for the rheumatologist to start the appropriate treatment earlier and more intensely. So that's it for today. Thank you very much for watching this learning case, and see you at the next time. Bye-bye.